I'm finna do my eyebrows so I can go to class. I don't be doing nothing, just my eyebrows. Depending on where I'm going determines if I'm going to actually put foundation on. I need to pluck my eyebrow hairs, but underneath, well, not underneath. I'm not gonna do it anytime soon. I feel like the lip liner is doing too much. I'm gonna take it off. Look at my little cotton swab thing. It was only $3 from Dollar General. I'm gonna get another one for my Q-tips. Yeah, the lip liner is doing too much. Girl, where are you going? Where are you going, to the club? Yeah, I like it way better without the lip liner. Now where did I put my lip gloss? I don't got time for this. I just don't. Oh shoot. I dropped my laptop. I'm just wearing a basic gray t-shirt, gray leggings, and my rainbow flip-flop. So I feel like this little coral purse for when I get out of class. I'm gonna put my wallet in here so I'm not carrying my book bag into the mall. The high is 82 today. Oh God. All the kids are crossing the street, including me. I just got out of class, guys. I'm walking to my car. It's hot. I hate when someone needs my park and I can't get settled into my car. I'm in the car. We are currently going to the mall because I have a graduation photo shoot coming up on the 20th. Today is March 3rd. I would purchase something online, but I just feel like it's too late. They'll give you an expected delivery date and it still won't come on time, and I just don't want to take that chance. And I want to make sure that the outfit fits because I won't have time to make returns. And I don't want to pay for faster delivery. So usually I do shop online, but this time around I do want to go to the mall. Plus, it's a pretty nice day outside, so I don't really mind. Dang, these cars do not be caring. It's a nice day outside. It's a weekday, so the mall shouldn't be crowded. And I'm going by myself. I don't mind being my own company. Like, I thrive off of being alone. So going to the mall, not having the rush to find something, you know, just hanging out with myself, talking to you guys is pretty cool. So that's what we are going to do right now. Class was pretty chill. We did an interview Jeopardy in my portfolio class. Just some interview preparation questions for when we do start interviewing for jobs. My professor brought chips, gummy snacks, Capri Suns, just a whole bunch of things. Like, we were literally just chilling in class today. So, yeah, class was cool. Now, let's go see if we can find something from the mall. If I don't find anything, I won't trip about it, but I do want to find something. But I'll talk to you guys once I get there because I don't have a car tripod. Y'all remember when I said I needed to pack a bag to go to the mall so I don't have to carry my book bag? I'm about to put my wallet in here and my car keys. Dang. Wallet, car keys, and some CarMax, and we're good to go. Everything fits. I got this bag from H&M when I was in Poland. I'm at Forever 21. That's the first store I'm going to walk into. Y'all, I can't talk long because they're playing music in here. But I wish Forever 21 had like sections. Like, I should have went to Ross. Like, they have stuff everywhere. Like, why can't they just have one section with long sleeves, another section with short sleeves, a section for dresses? That's ugly. But they did have some really cute purses on the wall. I'm gonna show you guys when I go back over there. But yeah, let me see what I can find. They still got their winter stuff out. I was gonna add music here, but then I was like, dang, these non-copyright songs be getting boring. Forever 21 is so unorganized. They still had their, like, cold weather things out. What they had, they didn't have in my size. These shoes was cute. But I didn't go too in-depth in Forever 21 because they was getting on my nerves. So I ended up leaving, and I said I was going to come back. I went back, but I never found shoes. You guys will see that later when I go to Auto. But I found some cute things, but it just wasn't giving my vibe for my graduation photo shoot. Like, that top would have been cute with some ripped jeans. You know, but I want one formal look and then one, you know, casual look. They have some cute purses, I would say that. This is cute. What kind of material is it? Good, how are you? Okay, I'm looking for a graduation dress. I'm taking pictures.
White one, right? Or it doesn't really matter.
I'm open.
So we have this dress right here. Okay. And a bunch of different colors.
Okay.
And then we also have it in tan.
Okay. I'll look around.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
This is when I knew I was in the wrong store. Like, she tried to suggest a tiny behind dress. No, ma'am. I kind of want to try this one on, but I feel like it's for short people. There's no point. This is the store I just left out of. Y'all, how did I end up in here? But these are cute for summer. I wish I had them in black as well. I need a medium in black. They just have smalls. My feet cannot fit in that. And I don't want a white pair because they're gonna get dirty too fast. I saw these already, but you can't really see. You can't really see the pink label. I found some more, but they don't have my size. Please, God. Yay. Okay. Now I'm in all dough looking at shoes. But I'm probably just gonna get my shoes from Forever 21. I'm gonna go back and try to look again. I walked in here because I saw this bag, but then I was like, where am I going? But those, I'm not gonna lie, those black ones are cute as freak. Maybe I can find something in Edge, a dress in here. So I ended up finding this store in the mall called Edge, and they had so many dresses. They had some club outfits. They had some, look at them jeans, girl. That dress is cute. Remember that purple dress. That's important to know, okay? I'm about to try both of these on. They will both go good with a garnet heel because y'all know my school's colors are garnet. So I'm about to try it on and see. So I got this dress in black and that color you see hanging on the wall, tan, beige, nude, whatever. Same size, but the black fits tighter than this tan. I really did like this one. It's cute. I could pair it up with some heels. Doesn't have to be garnet. I don't know if I'm gonna wear my cap with this dress, but I thought it was cute. I like the ruffles. I look like SpongeBob, but not too boxy, you know. I don't have hips, so there's that. This dress is the same purple dress that y'all saw on the mannequin, but it just did not look like me. No, it just didn't look like what it looked like on the mannequin on me. Like they had the string going wrapped around the neck. It's cute though, but it just, I wasn't feeling it at all. I made it back to my car. I even got some Cinnabon. I got a Cinnabon, talking about some Cinnabon. I got a Cinnabon. I'm about to get some of it now, but I'm gonna show you guys everything I got when I get home. I just put it all into this Victoria's Secret bag, and I did end up finding a dress. I'll show you guys when I get home. What I need to do is figure out what I'm actually eating for lunch. It's 3:16, so it's time for me to get back on my side of town before traffic starts, because I don't know, people might be trying to leave work early and I'm not trying to be caught up in that traffic, but I am about to bite into this. This looks so good. I'm about to see what it's hitting for. I made it back home and I finished my Cinnabon a few minutes ago, but I also made a sandwich. I just threw some sandwich meat, bacon, and cheese on it. We ran out of tomatoes. Once I find my iPad, I'm going to turn on This Is Us and just chill out. It's the next day. I'm about to make some coffee. It's actually 2 days later. Jeez. This right here is brand new. This is so good, y'all. If you don't like caramel, try this now. Ooh, pretty. I am currently at a food truck. The Slutty Vegan food truck. And this line is so long. The parking is ridiculous. Look at all these people, bro. This is the end of the line. My mom's in the purple. I'll show you guys when I get out. This line is so...
Or you would have known the line was gonna get ridiculous.
They expect to be here till 3.
So we needed to get here probably by 9:30, 10 o'clock. So next time you know.
It's 11:39 a.m.
Get a little lawn chair and sit down.
We're still in line.
Theoretically, we'll see. He's gonna see if there are any more.
They took down the sold out post on Instagram too.
So hopefully we'll still be able to get 2 burgers each.
We were on thin ice. We were on thin ice.
Are we getting tickets?
Yay.
Hey, babies. Okay. Y'all excited about Slutty Saturday?
Andy.
Columbia?
Yes.
Yes. Say, hey, Slutty Gang.
Hey, Slutty Gang.
Biggie Cole. Do we want everybody to be served today? We're excited y'all here. Y'all need to know that. What's up?
One eternity later.
Everybody got it. Everybody got it. Everybody got it. Have a hand with me. 1, 2, 3. PPY, we gon' get you slutified. ATL slut. ATL slut.
The things people do for a burger.
My lower back.
I'll never do this again. Why did we do this in the first place? This is whack. Y'all wouldn't believe how long we've been sitting here. I'm ashamed, I'm embarrassed. I'm ashamed and I'm embarrassed that I've been here this long over a Slutty Vegan burger. I'm dehydrated and I'm starved. We've been through morning, noon, and night.
Yep. Still no food.
They should be ashamed because they have a pop-up shop at the order. Like, the orders and pop-up shop is all at one table, and it's only one lady doing it. So people have been standing in line all day because of that.
Since 11:30, y'all.
Since 11:30. Some people have been here since 10:15 a.m. and didn't leave until 1:30 p.m. Let me pay attention for my name. I just placed my order like 10 minutes ago. It is 6:13,
and we've been here since 11:30.
That's a shame.
Have a good night.
Thank you, y'all. Be safe.
Thank you. You too.
We did do an entire shift, and I'll never do that again. That should be criminal.
I gotta pee so bad.
That is criminal to have people waiting that long for food. She talking about her legs is stiff.
They are numb.
Oh,
and stiff.
My gosh.
Oh.
I ain't never doing that again.
7 hours. 7 in line.
That's embarrassing. That's embarrassing.
And I stood the entire time.
You didn't sit down that once.
Not once, because I can't. My back. I wouldn't have been able to get up.
I got a one night stand, y'all. And we also got some fries. And I also got some fries, y'all. These fries are so good.
I'm doing something wrong.
This is good, y'all.
Yeah,
this is real good.
We all doing something wrong.
My mom got a tan standing in the line. I did
my
too.
Fork.
Y'all, look at the tan I got from standing in the Slutty Vegan line. I feel clean though. For a burger.
All burnt. Looking like a lobster.
So before I go downstairs to eat my second Slutty Vegan burger, I'm finna warm it up in the air fryer for breakfast. What time is it? It's 10 o'clock a.m. Yes, that's what I'm finna eat for breakfast because I stood in that line all dang day yesterday. I might as well eat it for breakfast. But I just wanna talk about this. I'm not gonna go on a rant. I just wanna point out a few things that Slutty Vegan can do in the future for when they do food trucks. That line was so long. It started from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m., y'all. We put up at 11:30. Terrible idea. So when we got there, the parking lot was full to capacity. There were people blocking each other in parking spots. That was a red flag. Another thing, we had to park in a different parking lot, the building next to where the food truck was. There was an event going on. There was an event going on while the food truck was outside, and I guess that event had correlation or ties with Slutty Vegan. This brand called OTG Athleisure, and I guess that was the event's vendor. We finally found a park. We got in line. We were waiting. Then this man
comes. Y'all seen him in some previous clips, and he's just talking, you know, hyping the line up, because obviously it's an event. And he's like, do y'all have a ticket? And we're like, no, we don't have a ticket. So then everyone's talking about, oh, we might not be able to get a burger because we don't have a ticket. Like, there was a lady who had got the last ticket, and everyone was just waiting to see if they'd be able to provide more tickets. So luckily, we got a ticket. By this time, we're waiting for 2 hours. I was out there for a total of 7 hours, y'all. Y'all need to go look at my TikTok because that video is definitely blowing up right now. No, someone said, y'all standing in line for a Beyond Burger. Please get help. Oh my gosh. But anyways, by the time we got our ticket, we've been in line for 2 hours. So it's like 1:30. I saw someone post on Instagram, because Slutty Vegan shared it on their stories, that someone got there at 10:15 a.m. and didn't leave until like 1:15 p.m. They were there before the food truck even opened. Waiting. We haven't ate breakfast, we haven't ate lunch, I haven't drunk any water, any juice, no nothing, because I was not prepared to be in the line longer than an hour. I had no idea it was gonna be that long, y'all, what the heck? So, after we waited for 4 hours, I'm like, let me walk up to see if I can find us something to drink. People are pulling out umbrellas, cookout chairs, all this is red flags, because now y'all getting comfortable. This is ridiculous. I walk up there, there's nothing else to drink. There's one lady, y'all. One lady taking orders. And that same lady taking orders is also selling merch simultaneously. That doesn't make sense, Lady Vegan. You need to have a table of 2 to 3 people taking orders and then another table to sell your merch, your t-shirts, your hats, your Slutty Vegan seasonings. What else they had? They had pies. Why is there one person, one table, that table filled with merch, that one lady taking orders and selling merch? All of this, it's just not working at all. And I didn't realize that until the 5th hour that was going on at the front. I'm like, what the heck? So I told my mom, and it's like, okay, well, we waited this long. What's the point of turning back? They shift the line to the other side. Now we can see the Slutty Vegan truck head on. At first, this was the truck and this was the line, like behind it. So you couldn't really see the front of the truck. But finally, we could see the front of the truck, if that makes sense. So we see them, they see us. So it's like, okay, maybe now that the cooks can see us, they'll see how many people are still waiting in line, and maybe they'll make this thing go faster. No, we're standing in line for another hour and a half, I would say. No, at this point it had to be the 7 hour mark. So at this point we've been in line for 6 hours and 30 minutes. And I wanna say at that time, we finally made it to the front. My mom didn't sit down at all. I sat down on the concrete or curb maybe like 4 to 5 different times in like small little increments because I didn't want my mom sitting up by herself. Like, she did not sit down at all. She got sunburnt. We went through all the freaking times of the day, morning, noon, evening. We didn't leave out that parking lot until 7 o'clock. And even after you made your order, y'all, even after you placed your order, you had to wait even longer, like 30 to 45 minutes. But because I was in the back, I wouldn't say I'm at the back, but I'm in the back. Luckily, I didn't have to wait for my food longer than like 20 to 30 minutes. But it's like, looking back, that is so stupid of me. That's so stupid. Of course, Slutty Vegan don't care because they making their money regardless. Having one lady taking orders and selling merch at the same time just does not flow. Like, they definitely need a system where people can place their order on the food truck, and then once their order's ready, they walk to the food truck and pick it up. Nobody should be standing in line all dang day. Like, it's 2022, technology, let's use it, okay? We use it for everything else. Why can't we use it for things such as this? That was nonsense. That just helps with tickets. That helps with people waiting outside in the heat. That helps with knowing your count, because a man was going up and down the line counting to see how many people were in line. At one point he was like, okay, so originally on the Slutty Vegan post, there was like a maximum of two burgers. And then at one point when we're almost to the front, they're like, okay, you guys can only get one burger because we have more shrimp than we have meat. We're like, what the heck? So you mean to tell me all this time I can only get one burger now? It was like they added something to the menu. It was the whole boy, and that was made out of shrimp rather than meat. I was cool with it. At this point, I was not leaving. But then he comes back, and he's like, okay, we did another count. Turns out y'all can get two burgers again. Moral of the story is I waited in that line for 7 hours. That was unnecessary. I feel like there were different things that could be done to prevent. My stomach's growling. Oh my gosh, shut up. I feel like there were different things that could be done to prevent people waiting in line for so long. I'm not a business expert. I obviously support Slutty Vegan. I'm not down talking them. I'm just saying, like, that was just unacceptable. And I don't think enough people are talking about it, which is why I made the post on my TikTok. Because yeah, we can support these businesses, but if something's wrong, something's wrong. That's unacceptable. Nobody should be waiting in line for 7 hours. Nobody. I would rather y'all turn me around. I sound like a fool. I would rather them turn me around rather than having us wait 7 hours. That's greed. Isn't that greed? Are they taking over the world? I sound crazy, but I just had to give out that spiel. I've been talking about this for 9 minutes and 55 seconds, so I'm gonna just stop. Y'all be respectful in the comments. Let me know how you guys feel about that. I also made a TikTok, so y'all go check that out because that junk is blowing up. How many views I got? I posted that this morning not knowing that it was gonna do that. Currently at 1,642 views. My burger was good though. I'm finna go eat my second one. I got 2 one-night stands. My mom got a one-night stand and a sloppy toppy. Last thing I wanna say before I finish this little part of my video is huge shout out to those that were working on that food truck all day to feed us, because one thing they was gonna do, they was gonna give us our burgers. And I will say that the customer service was great. All of the workers were so nice. Even after them being out there for that long, because I know it was hot, they were taking orders back to back. It's just little things that could have been done differently, but I'm not complaining. Am I complaining? I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just saying, okay, whatever, I'm done talking about it. So yeah, let's go eat. Let's go eat our Slutty Vegan burger for breakfast that we stood in line for, or that I stood in line for 7 hours. Okay, I'm gonna put it in the air fryer. Can I just say one more thing? It was just little things. Okay, I don't know. I just don't. Okay, we already know I'm a fool for standing in line for 7 hours. But the whole time I'm thinking, when I first got there, I didn't think I was going to be there longer than an hour. And then I'm like, if they already have the menu cut down to a point where you can only choose from 4 burgers, you can get a maximum of 2 burgers, and you can't add or customize the burger. And it's a burger. You just add toppings. I don't know. I don't work in the food industry, so y'all let me know how y'all feel about that. Like, why was the line so long? Other than one person taking orders and selling merch at the same time, what could have been the problem? Please let me know. I am genuinely asking. Now I am done. Let's go heat up my burger. Why did my mom cut a piece of my burger? Talking about she didn't know this one was mine. We had that conversation last night. Don't get me started. Gotta get the fries at the bottom of the bag. Every seasoning. Tell me why I dropped some of my fries on the floor. I had to go back in the fridge and steal some of my mom's fries since she wanna act like she didn't know this burger was mine. So I'm gonna take some of her fries. Y'all, I need some more clothes. I feel like I'm wearing the same thing over and over again. The crazy thing is, I don't really go anywhere. Like, I'm always in the house. I'm a homebody. So then when I actually want to go somewhere, I can't find anything to wear because all of my clothes are, all the clothes that I buy are for school. Like this shirt I have on now, it's a size large graphic tee. That ain't cute. I'm going bowling and I want to be cute while I'm bowling. I look like I'm going to class. Because I already had my mind set up that when I purchased this, this was for class. Not to go bowling or just do fun things when I do decide to go out. My whole closet needs an update, but I realized that I didn't even show you guys everything that I got from the mall. Too busy worrying about Slutty Vegan. When did I go to the mall? I went to the mall a few days ago and I still ain't show y'all. I'm about to show y'all right now once I finish lotion up my feet. Bath and Body Works Endless Weekend. It smells really good. And I am gonna spray that body mist, honey. Honey. So, when I went to the mall, I got two pairs of slides. Y'all know I was looking for a black pair, so I got a black pair that just says pink. And then I have this blue pair because I thought it would be perfect for the spring, and summer is around the corner. But spring is first, obviously, but I still think this is a really pretty color. I ended up going with this dress for my graduation photo shoot. I thought it was perfect for the formal outfit. It has a slit on the side. It was just giving more than the black outfit. The black outfit just wasn't looking right on me. The black outfit had me walking around looking like SpongeBob. I also ended up getting a strawberry pound cake single wick candle from Bath & Body Works. They had a sale on the single wicks. They were $6, I think. And I also got a wallflower for free. I ended up using my reward on that. But y'all, I peeped that Airwick wallflowers smell way better. Well, the scent is stronger, I would say, than Bath & Body Works wallflowers. Like Airwick is up there, y'all. Y'all need to try out Airwick. Save your coin if you're not trying to spend money on wallflowers from Bath & Body Works. I definitely recommend Airwick. I'll never turn on Bath & Body Works because their candles are top tier, okay? I'm just saying that Airwick plugins are better than Bath & Body Works wallflowers. I said what I said. But yeah, I'm going bowling. My mom is cooking dinner. So I'll probably just eat when I get back. It's 3:34 p.m. right now. I should be leaving in the next 10 minutes or so.
What bag am I wearing?
Is this bag cute? Or am I doing the most? I'm taking this white bag. Why is it so noisy? Do your job. Discreetly. Car keys. Garage door opener. I don't know where my lip gloss is, so we're just gonna ride with CarMax for now. Oh, found it. I'm gonna spray some Fruity Magnolia on me from Dossier. Use my code in the description box below to get some money off. And I also said I was gonna spray my body mist. I don't care. I'm gonna layer up just a little bit. Okay. Smell like something. I have Sour Patches in my purse because last night I went to go see Batman. That movie was
either that or I just didn't understand the storyline for me to care.
I just did my eyebrows today. Y'all know I just like doing my eyebrows, letting my skin breathe. But we still gotta have a nice brow, a nice solid brow. And when I say solid, I mean quality, not the thickness. I do not feel like driving. I hate driving. I'm thankful and blessed that I am able to drive myself places when I need to go somewhere, but it's just like a job. It's like a task within itself. People actually come bowling on Sundays. Parking lot is full. Do they even have any lanes open? I'm just trying to bowl. What are y'all? Go home. Y'all need to go home now. I do not like being around a lot of people. I just don't. It's basically a pizza place where you can customize the pizzas to your liking. I'm finna bust down.
ended off my night with a glass of wine. I'm going to go ahead and end this video here. I hope you guys enjoyed this week's vlog. Please subscribe if you haven't already. Give me a thumbs up and leave a comment down below. See you guys in my next video.